O'Brien's come under the spotlight.
Oh, Cruzy, that was solid, yeah?
Easy game.
See what, I love my job, and I'll tell you why I love my job. I stand here and I get the opportunity to test golf clubs like these. Now, these pop into my hands very regularly, but not something so cool and so beautiful looking. It is sleek, clean looking, guys. I don't even know what to say anymore. You can see I get goosebumps when I hit golf clubs like this. But I know you guys got a lot more info. Me, I'm going to stroll around and enjoy this down the road. Enjoy.
Cheers, Cruzy. Okay, PJ, me and Cruzy loves this club. And I can see why by just looking at it myself. You're the tech guy, so you got to tell me and the viewers, everybody out there, what has Cruzy
jumping
about?
Out of his skin
exactly.
By the looks of things walking down there. Look, it's a forged iron, so let's be honest. There's not much that you can do with a forged iron, although Cobra has done quite a bit in this. Called the King Forged Range. What I quite like is that it's a combination set. It's from 4-iron to pitching wedge, but your 4, 5, 6-iron is the CB. And then your 7-iron down becomes the MB.
Wait a minute here, PJ. You know, let's take it back a little bit for the viewers out there. You and I know what CB and MB means. So just simplify it for everybody else out there.
100%, Bella. So we'll start off with the CB. So it stands for cavity back. So if you have a look at it, your weighting is positioned around the perimeter of the golf club. That effectively makes your sweet spot a little bit bigger. So if you miss it, you get away with a little bit more. MB, muscle back. So where the CB had the perimeter weighting, all that weight is positioned in one position here, obviously centralizing it behind the face. This is for the traditionalist golfer that wants to work the golf ball, hit it high, hit it low, hit a little fade, hit a little draw, etc. This club becomes very, very workable when your longer clubs, the CB helps you a little bit if you do miss it.
A little bit more forgiveness.
That's it.
PJ, I've noticed something here as well. I mean, there's a round little silverish spot here. I'm assuming this is tungsten.
Ah, well spotted there, Bells. 100% correct. You know, that is indeed tungsten weighting. The problem with the traditional blade or semi-bladed golf club is the center of gravity sits quite close to the hosel of the club,
yeah.
Or on the heel of the club. So by center of gravity, I mean the sweet spot sits quite close to those. Cobra have tried to fight that a little bit by putting tungsten weighting in the toe, which moves the sweet spot back to the middle of the golf club.
Okay,
so it's a small little touch, makes a big difference.
Yeah, I guess it gives it a little bit of stability also throughout. 100%,
yeah. 100% correct. The whole idea behind this, obviously, Bells, is consistency. Consistency in flights, ball control, the works. What is interesting to note, this is the exact shaft Ricky Fowler plays. Not the X, not a specialized version.
Stock standard.
What comes out in the club is what he plays, which is a testament to how good the shaft actually is.
The shaft actually is, yeah. That was a mouthful. You cannot add and subtract anything. This is for the purest of pure players. Somebody between the handicaps of 5 going all the way down. I just make it into this category, by the way. So why don't you run on down and give these clubs a try?